Hi, questions in analysis in this textbook. Question one, show that the function defined by this one is continuous uniquely at the point x equals 1. Solution, note that the set Q and the set R minus Q are dense in R. If x0 is a rational number, and x0 is not equal to 1. For any positive number delta, there is an irrational number x such that x is in this interval. Then we have this inequality. We choose delta equals this number, which is greater than 0. Then there is an irrational number x such that the absolute value x minus x0 is less than delta, so that the absolute value fx minus fx0 is greater than delta. This implies that this limit does not exist for this case. Now, consider the case where x0 is an irrational number. Then, for any positive number delta, there is a rational number x such that x is in this open interval. Then, we have this inequality. We choose delta equals this number, which is greater than 0. Then, there is a rational number x such that the absolute value x minus x0 is less than delta. So the absolute fx minus fx0 is greater than 2 delta, which is greater than 0. This implies this limit does not exist for this case. We thus conclude f is not continuous at the point not equal to 1. Now, consider the case x0 equals 1 for any epsilon greater than 0. If absolute x minus 1 is less than epsilon over 2, then absolute fx minus 3 is less than epsilon. This says f is continuous at the point 1. We thus conclude f is only continuous at the point 1. Question 2. Let f be the function defined by this one. What are the points where f is continuous? Solution. Note that the set Q and the set R minus Q are dense in R. If A equals B, then we see that F is continuous on the domain of F. Now, suppose that A is less than B. We have this inequality. Case 1. X0 is a rational number, and X0 is not equal to a plus b over 2. For any positive real number delta, there is an irrational number x such that x is in this open interval. Then we have this inequality. Choose this delta, which is greater than 0. Then, because x is in this open interval, we have this inequality. So the absolute fx minus fx0 is greater than this positive number. This implies this limit does not exist for this case. Consider the case 2. X0 is not a rational number. Then x0 is not equal to a plus b over 2. For any positive real number delta, there is a rational number x such that x is in this open interval, then we have this inequality. Choose this positive number delta, then there is a rational number x such that this inequality holds. So absolute fx minus fx zero is greater than this positive real number. This implies this limit does not exist for this case. We thus conclude this limit does not exist for point x0 not equal to a plus b over 2. Consequently, f is not continuous at the point x0 not equal to a plus b over 2. Now, consider the case x0 equals a plus b over 2. Let epsilon be a positive real number. We have this one. We choose delta equals epsilon. Then, for any real number x such that absolute x minus a plus b over 2 is less than delta, we have absolute fx minus a plus b over 2 is less than epsilon. This implies we have this limit. So, f is continuous at the point a plus b over 2. We thus conclude f is continuous only at the point a plus b over 2. Thanks for watching. Bye.